Say that again.
Thank you.
And eventually, I moved from fighting for change from the outside to making change from the inside. And still, never could I have imagined I would stand here today taking the third oath of office to lead this great city.
She's being murdered.
She's being detained. Okay? She's only being detained. This is...
here rising.
Thank you.
Now, I know sometimes it's hard to keep this perspective. Taking care of tomorrow seems wrong when there are so many problems today. And like you, I'm not satisfied if muni trains are too crowded or if a homeless person spends the night outside in the rain. I'm not happy about traffic and congestion, Senator Feinstein. Even though we're right to be building a new subway or we're right to be replacing all of our sewers, I'm especially unhappy, heartbroken really, when I see someone lose their apartment or get priced out of their neighborhood. And I won't stop until we build better trust between law enforcement and the communities they're sworn to protect, especially young people of color.
Tournament.
to stand here as a justice for all the black folks. We are demanding, we're not asking, we're not begging that these third fires are resigned. We are not asking, we are not begging that all of the officers who were involved in the murder of Mario Woods be brought up on charges. We are not asking, we are not begging that the independent investigation goes forward, and not by San Francisco Police Department, not by San Francisco Police Commission, because they cannot investigate themselves. We are over 40 organizations here in San Francisco, all colors, gender, belief system, different religions, and we are standing together as one.
Yeah.
One unit, one unit, one belief that we are going to seek justice for Mario Wynn. My name is Felicia Jones. I am with SEIU 1021. I am one of the leaders of Justice for Mario Woods Coalition, and as you see, we mean business. You cannot continue to kill our people. You cannot continue to kill black and brown people here in San Francisco and think it's okay. You cannot shoot down a human being or shoot him more than 20 times like he's an animal, and then it's okay that he can only be suspended for 10 days and go back to work. We are not accepting it. We are putting the city of San Francisco on notice that we want
justice!
Independent investigation.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Fire chief, sir.
Yes.
And charge this cop with murder.
Yes.
Everybody was saying, one time, independent investigation.
Under these challenging times, when we face a police state for exercising our rights under the Constitution, where our rights are curtailed, then under these circumstances, labor cannot be quiet, labor cannot be comfortable in our homes, labor must be on the street. These are nothing more and nothing less than summary executions without due process, because the laws are so broad, they allow anyone in a colored community to be shot in the back. They allow anyone in a colored community to be shot while peacefully eating their burrito. And we cannot be silent.
We must
lose
men.
Black lives matter.
Black
lives matter.
Will not be stopped.
Kill racism. Kill capitalism.
No peace.
Kill white supremacy.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
This is where we have to stand together.
That's right.
We have to let this Mario Woods incident be the reason we stand together.
That's right.
And fight this capitalistic bullshit that's going on.
That's right, Green.
People getting evicted. People getting gentrified. The homeless. We need mental care. And we need to get this shit together. And it starts with the justice for Mario Woods.
Genocide is gentrification.
To be ashamed. We are better than that. I am with the Royal Chicano Air Force. I am an artist, and I have lived in this city for many, many decades, and we need to be
scared of justice if justice has no color. All lives matter, and justice needs to be enforced for all of us. We all pay taxes, and we all here collectively. For Mario Woods, I plead for peace, and I plead for justice. Let's stand together, and we are no longer, and we will hold this city accountable.
They shot this young man 20 to 40 times.
We will not be silent.
We will not be silent.
We will not be silent.
The police killed this man.
We will not be silent.
We will not be silent.
My church!
Public execution!
I was discussing the Mario Woods Coalition, and I want you to know this is not just one day. This is not a sprint. It is a marathon.
Every day.
And I am putting Ed Lee on notice. Yeah. As long as you back up racist police and a culture of racism that oppresses people of color in San Francisco, we're coming for you.
Demanding justice. We will not stop. Enough is enough.
Black and brown people have been bullied. We have been intimidated on our jobs. We have been intimidated all over this city. They do not like black or brown people. The other day, I saw on the news a sister who threw her dog at her boyfriend for whatever reason. They hunted that woman down and arrested her for throwing a dog. Now, we all have pets. I don't have one, but all of us have pets, and they are important, too. But how much more is human life more than a dog? They shot Mario Wood 20-plus times.
40-plus shots.
20-plus times. It was an execution by fire.
Automatic destruction.
Disarm all pigs! We are
disarm the pigs!
And we're going to do it however we can. And so the chief cannot continue to go and have secret meetings with certain African American leaders. And we no disrespect to the leaders that he calls in, but the leaders do not speak for the community. We are the community. We are demanding justice. And so one thing that Mayor Lee needs to do, he needs to come and speak with us. We meet every Thursday at 350 Rhode Island, Suite 100, SEIU, 1021 Union Hall. London Breed needs to come and speak with us. Malia Cohen needs to come and speak with us. Every board and supervisor, with the exception of David Campos and John Avalos, who already came and spoke to our coalition, who again, in solidarity, believed in our work. We want to hear from the powers at be here in San Francisco. What is justice to you? How are you going to stand up to the racist text messages that you allow the police department to text back and forth with senior police officers, captains, sergeants, and call us black people niggers and nigger bitches and animals, and that we need to be hung in 2015? Come on now. Something needs to be done. And so we are not stopping. We are not stopping. We are here to say, as my sister Yanni said, we are putting the city and county of San Francisco on notice.
On notice. We will shut it down.
And if the pigs ain't have guns, they wouldn't have shot the brothers. Disarm the pigs.
Why do?
Well, I wait.
We're not our people.
Okay. The coalition, we are intelligent people. We know that to get our point across, we do not have to throw coffee on people. We know that we don't have to throw water on people. And those who did that was not part of our coalition. We have discipline.
You can ask the police. We help control
the capitalism
is this. Racism ain't going nowhere.
We know that the press and everyone else is looking for us to do something out of the ordinary to say
it don't matter who you elect
and
don't elect. As long as people got weapons in their hands, they're going to use them wrong.
And we do not
as long as people got weapons in their hands, they're going to use them wrong. They're going to abuse them.
What you see right here is that we stand together. We're standing together as one.
The media is going to divide us. My name is Mark Crosby. I'm with Black Lives Matter.
Go ahead.
The Last and Prevent Coalition. So I want to put out a call out to the people. You're going to see the East Bay and the world is going to see just how united we are.
Right.
The weekend of the 14th through the 18th, we are going to come together. Not just San Francisco, the whole East Bay. You are going to see, you just watch, and better than that, come out of your houses. This is the time. We can't rely anymore, my brothers and my sisters. We can no longer rely on our elected leaders. We have to rely on each other. We need to come together with a transformative kind of love. A transformative time. Just like Jeff was saying when we came together the other night at that march. It's got to be transformative, and you're going to see exactly what I'm talking about. So please, come out. If you want to specifically join in on a march, January 18th at 11 o'clock at the Oscar Inn or Ogawa Plaza on 14th and Broadway, you can come out and join us. Join us. Now is the time. We can no longer be isolated.
Okay. And the other thing that we're going to do, we're going to march on POA.
condone and support this racist behavior here in San Francisco, and we're saying to the POA, you do not govern us.
That's right.
And you do not govern us. And you
do not govern us.
We are not afraid of you.
That's when last year when John Avalos put in a resolution for Black Lives Matter, the POA got so upset and wrote all kind of nasty letters to all of the board of supervisors and they backed down. Well, we are going to tell the POA we're not backing
down. We're not going to back
down. We're going to take you on too. Power to the people!
Power to the people! Power to the people! Power to the people! Justice for Maria
Wood!
Justice for Maria Wood!
We can't stop!
We won't stop!
Until justice rains down on our community!
We can't stop!
We won't stop!
Until justice rains down on our community!